So OpenAI has recently launched their latest image generation model in their API. So the name of this model is gpt-image-1, and using this model we can generate as well as edit our images. So in this video I will be showing you how you can use this model and generate images with OpenAI API. So let's get started. First thing, just Google OpenAI API and select the first link, and make sure that you're already having an OpenAI or ChatGPT account, and you must also be having credits. You need to pay and get them. So you'll be taken to an interface like this. If you scroll down over here, at the end you'll be having this specialized models. We'll be having image generation. Click that, and if you scroll down, OpenAI has three models for image generation, which are DALL-E 2, DALL-E 3 and GPT image. GPT image is the latest one, the GPT 1 image that we saw, and DALL-E 2 is the first model and DALL-E 3 is the previous model that they have already launched. And here they are having the use cases. So DALL-E 2 is like the lower cost image generation model, whereas DALL-E 3 has high quality also, and GPT image is the best one. So you can just choose depending upon your use case. If you want like lower cost and low quality, you can go with like DALL-E 2. And in case if you want like in medium level, you can go with DALL-E 3. And if you want the best and the latest one, GPT image is the best for you. So now let's just see the pricing. So if you go to this pricing tab here, this is for image generation. They have compared GPT 1 image with DALL-E 3 and DALL-E 2. And this is the price per image that's going to cost us. GPT 1 image comes with low, medium and high quality, whereas DALL-E 2 just comes with the standard one, and DALL-E 3 has the HD quality also. So you can just compare this and take a decision based upon your quality as well as the dimensions of the image that you want to generate. So now let's get started with the code. So if you go to that exact same space like image generation under specialized models, if you just scroll down here, we are having the sample code for generate images. So we'll be having the code in JavaScript, I guess, by default. In this tutorial we are going to do it for Python. So I'll just go here and click Python, and as you can see, we are giving the GPT image 1 model, and the prompt is there. We are getting the image as the result, and the image is in base64 format, and we need to just decode that image and then we can just store it. So quite a simple code over here, and we can just copy this code and go here, and yeah, I'm having my Visual Studio code opened. You can just open the editor of your choice, create a new Python file and paste the code over here. So that's good. And we need to also install OpenAI library, and I guess base64 is an inbuilt library. Base64 is an inbuilt library, so we don't have to, you know, install that. So let's just go to our terminal and make sure that you're having Python already installed on your system. If you don't have, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. So I will just go with pip install OpenAI. This is the command, and hit enter. Yeah, it will get installed. Next thing is we need to set the OpenAI API key. So for getting the API key, just come to the home interface of the documentation. To the top, you'll be having your profile. Select it and click on your profile. Here we are having the API keys. Click here and you can just click on create a new secret key. So you can just give it a name, and I'll go with default project. You can configure the permissions. Once you've done that, click on create secret key and make sure that you don't share this key with anyone, and you can just copy the key and click on done. And you are also having an option to delete the key. So you can just store this key in an environment variable and access it over here. Since it's just a demo, I'm directly going to assign it. Okay, so you'll be having this client equal to OpenAI thing, right? We're just going to come to the next line, and here it's going to be API underscore key equal to, and within double quotes, just paste the secret key that you're having. Yeah, this is now good. And here we are having the prompt, and GPT 1 is the image. So directly this particular image will be getting stored in our directory itself, because we are just specifying the path like this. We are not giving a full folder structure over there. So before creating an image, let's also see what are the parameters that we can pass to our generate image function. So for that, you can just go back to the image generation under specialized models. If you scroll up here, we are having this image API thing. You can just open this in a new tab. So this will basically give us all the parameters that we can use for create image endpoint. So as you can see, we are having the code that we saw earlier. So first one is the prompt. So this is the input prompt that we are giving, and these are the character lengths. For example, for GPT-1, we are having the maximum length as 32,000 characters. That's a lot. And for DALL-E 2, we are having 1,000, and 4,000 for DALL-E 3. Like, I mean, 32,000 is a lot. I don't even know like who's going to add such a big prompt for image. So next we are having the background parameter. This is an optional one, whereas the prompt is a required one. So this basically allows us to set the transparency, whether it should be transparent, opaque, or auto, the background. And this parameter is only supported for GPT-1 image. It's not coming in DALL-E 2 or 3. And next one is going to be the model. This is like self-explanatory. And next is the moderation, like you can control that also over here. And another cool thing is the number of images, n, which is optional. And by default, it will generate one image in the output. But here we are having an option to generate between 1 and 10 images for a single prompt. And for DALL-E 3, it's only one output format. It supports PNG, JPEG, and WebP. Quality. So as I told you in that pricing, for GPT-1, we are having high, medium, and low. For DALL-E 3, we are having HD and standard. For DALL-E 2, we are having standard. And next one is the response format. This is quite interesting because I remember generating images with URL. Like OpenAI will give us a URL back, and with the help of that URL, we will be able to view that image. So as you can see, the images that are generated by DALL-E 2 and DALL-E 3 are returned, and it can be a URL or a base64 JSON. And these URLs are valid only for 60 minutes because they are getting hosted by OpenAI. So it's not permanent. You need to like save the image in your own database or download it. But this parameter isn't supported for GPT-1 image, which always returns a base64 encoded image. So the thing is, GPT-1 doesn't generate a URL. It only gives us base64 images. And next is going to be the size. This is basically the dimensions of the image. We are also having the default dimensions, or it can be any of these. So it's based upon the model. We are having like specific dimensions over there. And next is going to be the style. So this must be one of vivid or natural. I mean, I guess nobody's going to use style. We can like literally specify that in the prompt itself. So these are some of the important parameters. You can just, you know, use it like depending upon your use case over here. So, well, that said, now we can just go and run our code. I'm just going to go with model and the prompt. So let me just go and change the prompt. So for running this is going to be Python, your file name, .py, and hit enter. So we have got the output over here. It gets saved as a new image in the exact same folder. And if you get any error saying permission error, you need to verify in your organization when running this command, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. I've done a tutorial on that. So this is the image that I get. I guess this is the highest quality image, like, yeah, because we didn't pass any parameters. I guess by default, it's going to go with the highest quality. Auto, it's going to be the default value, will automatically set the best quality for a given model. So, and the image also looks so good, literally looks like a real DSLR image. So now let's just go and pass some parameters over here. So I'll just go with this background one. So I'll just go here, background, and the value must be transparent, opaque, or auto. So I'll just go with background, and it's going to be this one, transparent, and next. And let me also change the quality. So I'll just go with the quality one. I'll just set with medium quality for this one. So it's going to be medium. And we need to put everything within double quotes also. So the prompt will be like a variable, so don't put that. And apart from that, everything should be coming within double quotes like this. I guess n is 2, that's fine. It can be of type integer because it's given integer, yeah. We are also having the data type to that near it, so make sure that you're passing the right one. All right, and let's run it now. So if you're getting any errors when running the code after adding new parameters, it's because you have like the older version of OpenAI's Python library. So to upgrade it to the latest one, you need to just run this command, okay? Pip install --, upgrade OpenAI. So here I'm setting the n as 2, but I'm just having the single image, like I'm just getting the single one. So I guess if you want to access the second image also, you can just like copy this, and I guess it's going to be data of one. So you can just, you know, convert that image and save it also. I guess that's how it's going to work. And this is the image I have sent with transparent background and medium, the exact same prompt, and this is the image that I get. So that's not bad. The medium image is also like looking super hyper realistic. The background is transparent as we have given in our query. So now this is fine, and let me also now show you a way how you can use this exact same code. Like we'll be sending the prompt from Postman's request body and getting the response back as an image. So now for this, we'll be creating a REST endpoint using Flask. So we just need to run the command pip install Flask, which is used to create a REST endpoint in Python. So that's good. Let's just go and import from Flask. So it's going to be from Flask import Flask with a capital F request comma send file. All right. So we will be requiring these things. And next, we also need base64, which is already there. And we'll be having the Flask variable. So it's going to be app equal to Flask, and it's going to be underscore underscore name underscore underscore. All right. So we just need to have this. And next, just come to the next line of your, you know, the OpenAI API key. We will be defining our route. So it's going to be at app dot route, and it's going to be slash generate image. You can have this and put a comma over here. It's going to be the operation type, which we refer by methods equal to square bracket. And this is going to be of type post. So let's put that between single quote. And next, have a function. It's going to be define. We have it as generate image and colon. And we need to do some corrections over here, because in this, we are not going to save it in our folder over here. We will be passing it to Postman. And another important thing is here, we don't require the prompt, because we will be sending the prompt from the body over here. So what we can do is we can just remove this prompt, and we need to write a code how we can access the prompt that we're going to send as a JSON over here. So for this, just come to the next line. It's going to be data equal to request, the one that we imported dot JSON. And this basically will fetch the entire JSON that we are sending over here. Like it will literally fetch the entire one. So we just need to access the prompt now. So for that, it's going to be prompt equals data dot get, and within double quotes, it's going to be prompt. All right. And next, we can just have a check condition. If the prompt is there, the value is not there or not, that's totally up to you. And now we need to put this entire piece of code inside our function. So we can just like cut this and paste it over here. Make sure that the indentation is correct. And I am not going to pass this in too, because I'm just going to access only one image, like data of zero. If you want, you can just access data of one also and like get hold of that. But I'm just going to pass here only one image. And next, we also need this. So cut this and put it inside our function. Be careful of the indentation. All right. And yeah, I guess this is good. Next, we can just directly send this image bytes as a return statement by using the send file that we have imported. So just come to the next line. It's going to be return. It's going to be send underscore file and open circular bracket. Inside it is going to be IO dot bytes, capital IO. I guess we need to import IO. So this is an inbuilt package. So just go to the top. It's going to be import IO and just scroll down. Yeah, bytes IO. And inside that, we need to pass our variable name, which is image bytes, which has our image. And we need to also pass some metadata, which is the return type. We call it as mime type over here. And it's going to be image slash PNG. And next one, as attachment, it's going to be false. And we have to have a name, which is download underscore name. It's called, we can just name it anything that you want. I'll just go with image.png. All right, so that's it. We are good now. We don't need this save stuff. Yeah, we have created our function, and next it's going to be the main function. So it's going to be if underscore underscore name underscore underscore double equal to space underscore underscore main underscore underscore colon, and we just need to use our variable, which is app dot run, to start the same Flask variable that we have used on the top. So that's the code, guys. You can just save it and same thing to run. And yeah, our application has started in this particular localhost. So you can just copy this, go to postman and change this to post, paste the localhost path, and you need to go to body and it'll be none by default. Click on raw and you need to change this to JSON. So you just need to like have this particular structure JSON. You need to have a prompt within curly bracket, and here you need to specify the image. So let's go with image of Earth. Yeah, that's going to be my prompt, and we need to also add the path over here. So for that, it's going to be slash gen image. Yeah, that's it. We are good now, and let me just send it. Okay, I've got the error false. Okay, I gave it as small f. It's going to be capital F. So let me just, you know, restart everything, send it again. Okay, we have got the output, and that took quite a long time to get. I don't know why this took so much of time, but we have got the image. I guess it's because of the transparency or something, that's why it took quite a bit of time. But we have got the image of the Earth. If you want to click and save it, you can just select save it to file and it will save it. But yeah, this basically does the job for us. And that's the video, guys. Do let me know in the comments what you think about it. I hope you'd have found this useful. Also check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of tutorials on OpenAI, Gemini AI, API and other AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.